Although MPC Machine comes with some default sounds to get you started, you're able to load your own samples in. To do this, access the MPC Machine menu using the correct method for your device. You can find out how this is done by looking at the tutorial accessing the menu. In short, Android devices with a physical menu button, this button needs to be pressed to access the menu, whereas devices without the menu button, you touch the LCD screen. This is all covered in the accessing the menu tutorial. So let's start importing some samples into our MPC machine. First of all, we need to find an empty bank, that is some empty pads where there are no sounds. To do that, we've got to switch banks. If you're not sure how to do this, look up the tutorial switching banks. Okay, so we have an empty bank. Now we're going to load some samples in. Access the menu, then go to import samples. The two links that you will see appearing on the right hand side are quite self-explanatory. The first one is the phone drive, which allows us to browse our phone's drive looking for samples. And the second one is the samples that we already have in memory. We're going to go to our phone drive and browse and look for some samples. Obviously, your device may differ. Press the green arrow to go up a directory. Use your finger to scroll up and down to browse through the list of all the contents within that folder, and tap on any item, such as a folder to go into it, or any audio file to play it. When you click on the audio file, it will automatically play if you have set audition sample to be on. Once the sample has been selected, at the top, a button will say assign this sample to this pad. What that means is the current pad you have selected, where the yellow square is, you can click that button and assign that sample that you just loaded to that pad. So if you went to assign it to pad number one, you'd make sure that the yellow square is on pad number one and then press that button. If you wanted to assign it to pad number two, you'd make sure the yellow square is on pad number two and then click that button. Watch how I do this. I've just assigned a sample to pad number one. Now I'm selecting pad number two. And I'll try and find the kick drum to go with that snare drum I put on pad number one. And that's it, that's the process. You repeat it over and over again, assigning samples to different pads until you have a bank of sounds that you're happy with. You can even do this while the sequencer is playing, so you can mix and match sounds. Thank you for watching this video. Hope you found it useful.